Hi, I'm Bryan Goodwin, and welcome to DownEast Outdoors. It's one of these crisp, cold fall mornings, late fall morning, and we are up in one of our favorite areas fishing for red drum. We've got a great show lined up for you, so stick with us. We'll be right back. Got him on. Oh, and it feels like a nice fish, too. Feels like a nice fish. Gosh, what a beautiful morning it is up here today, too. As you can see, there is just not a breath of wind. Started out the morning, I guess it was about 30 degrees on the thermometer this morning at first light. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, he's coming off the top. The water temperature's about 45 degrees this morning. And these fish in this cold water don't have quite the stamina that they do in the summertime. Whoa, he almost got me hung up in the trolling motor there. Oh, what a pretty fish this one is, too. Got him hung around his fin, but I think he is ready to come in. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Nice pretty drum, nice pretty drum. You know, I always bend the barbs down on my hooks when I'm drum fishing so that the hook comes out real, real easy. Their mouth is so hard and tough. And look what we have here. That is rather unique. That is a lead jig head from a previous fisherman that somehow managed to hook him right down in the belly. So we have definitely helped this guy out this morning. He's got some funny looking spots on him too. Giant tail, look at the size of the tail on that fish right there. That is what gives these drums so much power. So much power. But what a great start to the morning. That's definitely got my blood flowing. Helped warm me up a little bit. Let's get him back in the water. And we're gonna go over my strategy for this morning, how I'm starting out and how we're finding these fish and how we're able to catch these fish. As you can see, I'm using a spinner bait this morning. The water up here, although it is very, very cold, usually keeps a tea stain or a color to it because of the freshwater intrusion up here. Anytime you've got a colored water like this, especially this time of year when it's, you know, when the water's really cold, I like to use either a gold spoon or a spinner bait, something with some gold flash to catch the attention of the fish. And I really like the color white for a soft plastic. I really like the color white up here in in stained water. Now what I'm doing, as you can see that cast right there, I'm easing down this bank, easing down this shoreline, kind of casting up ahead as I go. Keeping the trolling motor pretty much at its absolute slowest speed. I call this prospect, and what we're doing right now is we're really looking for the fish, trying to find where the fish are holding. I know there are a lot of fish up here because I've been running trips up here for the past 3 or 4 weeks, and we have had just great, great amounts of success. We've caught well over 200, possibly up to 250 fish up here. Nice quality drum during the past 2 to 3 weeks. So I know the fish are up here. Caught them on my last trip. One thing about a spinnerbait, the reason I like it so much for prospecting is you can really cover a lot of territory with it. It's a bait that you can work relatively fast, although I do have to force myself to slow my presentation down this time of year because the water is it's so much colder. Like I say, it's about 45 degrees right now. And with this abundant sunshine and dark, muddy bottom, I feel like it'll get up into the upper 40s, possibly 50 degrees today. Little too tight to that marsh bank on that cast. But like I say, I have to force my... Got him. Oh, that was awesome. I thought that was going to be a busted cast because I cast it up into the edge of the marsh there. Got him. And what was I saying about these fish being a little more lethargic than they are in the warmer weather months? They're putting up a good fight this morning. I really feel like that sun, that bright, warm, late fall sunshine, once it has a chance to warm their backs, it really, really gets them going. And I should probably grab my dip net and pull that dip net up here, but one thing I like about a spinnerbait, I've got that grab hold right there. Oh yeah, oh yeah. They're really hitting the spinnerbait aggressive so far this morning. There we go. Pretty little spinnerbait, barb bent down. Oh, and I just love this class of fish. I just love this class of drum. They are so much fun. Look at the beautiful colors in him. The bronze, the red in his fins, the blue in his giant tail. And it's that big tail that they really get so much power out of it. Oh, what a blast. See down in his big old mouth there. Anyway, this fish feels cold down in that 45 degree water. Let's get him back over and we'll keep going over the strategy we're using this morning and continue to show you today how we find these fish and how we catch these fish. So stick with us. We'll be right back. Got him on. Another nice one. I knew we had come up on a place of schooling fish. Because I look down into the water, we're fishing probably in about 2 feet of water up here along this bank. I saw lots of stirred up mud. I call it smoke clouds because it almost looks like smoke coming up off the bottom. I know it's hard to see down in the water, but there's a nice smoke cloud right there. But it looked like to me that there was a school of fish up here, probably up in the dozens. Oh, wow. What a fight he's putting up. Trying to go under the boat on me. Come back out. There he comes. Oh. What was I saying about this cold water slowing these fish down? He's there putting up a good fight this morning. I am absolutely loving it. Come on, big boy. Come on, hon. Oh, yeah. Oh yeah, he really nailed that spinnerbait. I'm having so much fun with these fish up here this morning. I hope you are enjoying it too. I think we'll go over a little bit more about my strategy and the technique that I'm using to catch these fish. But you gotta keep in mind something this time of year. You can't catch fish unless you can find fish. Let's don't stop now. Let's get back out there and catch some more. Now I'm still using my spinner bait. Gold spoon, white paddle tail, and like I say, it is my most favorite prospect in lure. It's easy to change out, you know, the color of the lead head and the tail on these. But in this tea-stained water up here, this brackish water, white, a white tail is my favorite. And I tell you, something about that gold flash up here really, really works so well at grabbing the attention of these drum. I'm getting a little too close to the bank. Oh, I thought that was one, but it's not. And I'll tell you what, there are fish all in here. I am really seeing, oh, got him. And I was not even paying attention that time. It's a smaller one. Putting on a good show for us. There we go. Pretty little drum. This fish is probably just below slot, probably in that 16, 17 inch range. And it's probably about a year younger than those fish we've been catching. Beautiful little fish, very healthy. Get him back in. I feel great about our chances of picking up another one real quick. Like, there just seems to be, we really seem to have found a place along this bank that are holding fish. And, you know, that's part of my strategy, is to cover as much territory as possible working down this bank until I find an area that's holding fish. Now, you may work 100 yards of bank and not catch one, and then come to a stretch, you know, no longer than 20 or 30 or 40 yards, that's holding literally dozens and dozens, possibly over 100 fish. And if you stay quiet, keep your trolling motor on low or pole your boat, be careful and not stomp around in the floor of the boat. A lot of time you can stay within casting range of these fish without really ever spooking them too much. Now we are definitely spooking fish up here this morning, because I'm seeing all the little smoke trails or mud boils coming up off the bottom. But that's a good sign. What I'm trying to do is just kind of work through this area where we spook the fish, casting up ahead of the boat so that we can reach out and catch those fish out on the perimeter before we have a chance to spook them. Bear with me. Let's see if we can't pick one up here real quick for you. I'm getting a little far out off, actually getting a little too close into the bank, so I need to pull back out a little bit. I try to stay off the bank, but just within casting range. But as we caught that last fish, I drifted up just a little bit too close. So you want to keep your distance off the bank. So if you do spook the fish, you'll spook them either to the right or to the left down the bank and not spook them out into deeper water. Of course, this you know, this type of fishing, it's not a perfect science. And I don't claim that my strategy is a perfect strategy, but it works for us. Now I'm working this bait just as slow as I can make myself work it. These spinner baits, you really don't have to work them fast. All you need to do is work it fast enough to get that spoon to flash and that paddle tail on the soft plastic to, ooh, and I just had a small one come up behind it. That was pretty cool. If we've got time this morning and the fish cooperate, if we can pick up one more fish on this spinnerbait, I'll switch over to a gold spoon and show you how well that works. But I find myself, when I get excited, retrieving these spinnerbaits too fast. So I really have to make a conscious effort to slow down my retrieve. A bite. Got him. Oh, another nice one. I just love it when the camera's rolling and I can pick one up while the camera is rolling. To me, that's the ultimate, because you really get to oh wow. The biggest one I've seen all morning. I just saw free swimming down there, so we are definitely, oh wow, we are definitely in a hot spot. Don't seem to quite have as much stamina, although their initial runs are pretty powerful in this cold water. Ah, another nice fish. Gosh, you just gotta love it. You've gotta love it. I don't know that it gets much better than this time of year. I am up here in this bay. We are all by ourselves this morning. Beautiful, beautiful, crisp fall morning. Not a breath of wind. We're having to share the area with some duck hunters, but most of them are bailing out. It's getting too pretty for the ducks to be flying, so most of those guys are leaving. And gosh, that was so much fun. And I am so, so glad that you got to share the hookup and the fight that we had with this fish. We're gonna get him back over now. You stay with us. We'll be right back. Got it. I just switched over to this gold spoon. I love working a gold spoon, especially after you found fish, because it's, I don't know, it's just so fun to cast. It's easy to cast, it's easy to retrieve. It's probably the easiest lure to fish with that I have experienced. This is not a great big one, but he's got a lot of fire in him. And of course this gold spoon was tied onto a lighter rod. I've dropped down in a line class to about an 8. There we go. Now that fish that we just caught, I had switched over to a gold spoon. I really wanted to show y'all this morning how we can use a variety of different methods, tactics, and lures to catch these drum. But this is a gold spoon with a weed guard with a little small gold swivel at the top to keep the line from twisting. And gold spoons, they are super easy to cast. I mean, just so much fun to cast. So easy to work. Generally, the keys to working a gold spoon, I try to keep my rod tip down, and I try to have a medium, kind of a medium to fast retrieve with a gold spoon. Basically using the same strategy that we were using when we were fishing that spinnerbait. I'm working down the bank, casting up towards the bank. The gold spoon kind of wobbles and flips up above the bottom. So if you're working in a rocky area or an area with grass on the bottom, any types of hangs or snags on the bottom, a gold spoon works great. When I have a fishing party on board and they're not all that experienced with casting or retrieving with this type of fishing, once we've located fish, a lot of times I'll switch them over to a gold spoon. And it's really, it's a trouble-free lure that can be very, very effective. We're gonna pull the boat back off the bank just a little bit more. I've got better casting range with this gold spoon. It does not seem to have as much wind resistance as a spinnerbait does. That's the only drawback with a spinnerbait is your casting distance sometimes is reduced. Especially if you've got a breeze or the wind's blowing. But this gold spoon really seems to cut through the air. And like I say, once we found fish, it is very, very effective. Now I can see times, especially this time of year as the water temp's really getting down. If you're fishing out around the beach or the outer marshes where the water really is crystal clear, that a gold spoon may not be effective. But when you're up in this, up in these bays, creeks, places like this that kind of keep color in the water or brackish color in the water, during the winter time, gosh, that gold flash really, really gets their attention. Got him. Whoa. You know, I can sit here and talk about how good this gold spoon works all I want, but when you see it in action and you see it work, got 8 pound test mono on this rod and I really got to keep my drag fairly loose. You never know when your line's going to get a little nick in it or a weak spot in your line. And I tell you, that is one thing I hate to do. I hate to lose a fish that I have hooked up on. Tell you what, these fish this morning, come on, they're doing a lot of flipping and flopping in my line. Got around the fin a little bit. Come on, big fella. Give us just a second out of the water with you. We'll put you right back in. There we go. Woo! And what a nice one he is. Wow. Now I pinched that little weed guard down. Get him down a little bit. There we go. Pinch the barb down on that hook, makes it come out a lot easier. Wow, look at the thickness, look at the shoulders on him. Geez, what a pretty fish. I just can't get over how nice class of fish there are up here. And I tell you, we do this all the time during the late fall and winter months. If you have not had a chance to get out and experience this this cold weather, cold water drum fishing, you don't know what you're missing. You have got to give me a call and book a trip and hope that you get a day as pretty as it is this morning. We're going to get him back over and come back and see how many more of them we can catch. We are just having a great time fishing this morning, but we are running out of the time that we have to spend with you for this show. But I tell you what we're going to do. We're not going to stop fishing. So what you need to do now, make sure you tune in and join us next week, because we are going to continue this fishing trip with you on next week's show.